J at the beginning of the map. This time it went into Zekin. Take a look at how Sick has already taken C-Long control. The paranoia is coming out from Zoms as they try to get onto the site. Tans with just 9 health, not able to get anything more, but there's Dapper! You mentioned it earlier, the frenzy coming up big as Dapper gets 2, Zoms gets 1 as well. Zekin gets cleaned up. Sentinels will do the shock darts, are trying to push Def off, but he does manage to get the spike down. Dapper up in heaven, waiting for his teammates to show up. You've got Tans, you've got Zoms, you've got everyone. Coming back around, you expect to see a hot hands hit from Sick, and then the curves to flash through. The paranoia is going to come out as well. Tens dashes in, BCJ gets, does get one, excuse me, as Def gets one as well. Exit team to be able to hold fast. They do not give up a single inch. Rip. Ultimates, here comes the Cosmic Divide. The thing is, you've got to deal with Sick. Zoms has been given away. The Gravity Well is going to push him off as well. There's Sick, he gets flashed up. You've got a couple of additional resources.
Avatar here for
one. Zoms! Tom's not able to get it. The Hunter Fury's coming out as well. Sick is still alive. And the spike has it.
It's always a dice roll when you have that many people entering the site, Doug, and you haven't found a frag yet. It just means once that smoke drops, somebody's pants are going to be on the ground. We saw a few going down almost immediately. Aeryn, they are not leaving anything up to chance here. And then they just use the uplink to know exactly where they're going to be finding Tens. A 3v1 with the Operator is likely. We'll see if he keeps chances on the board with the first shot here.
And he is 1 point away from getting the Bladestorm online. So he could make some magic happen. Not going to spawn anyone on the...
May try to go fast towards A, but we do see Bladestorm is up now. And they just stand there for a quick photo from Tens.
Gonna keep it online. He did get tagged up. He's only down to 40 health. Shazam's down to 0 health. Tens is looking for more. And Pure is able to snatch him right out of the sky. Dapper's gonna drop as well. It was just light buys. The Bladestorm being the one.
They're gonna be able to hold off here. So causing Sentinels to do a bit of a save. Nice shot by Sick. You cannot let that happen. Zekin. Def does drop back and get a little retribution on that frag. It looks like more exits for Zom will be what's on the menu. He gives himself up here. It looks like he wants to draw the fight. I like this.
Oh, they may not. They may have to deal with this. Yeah, they're starting to move up. Zom's not able to get any.
And they just get the creep in. The space is given. Shazam goes down. And they were hoping that Xset was going to use something kind of big enough to see utility that would have let them know it's safer to go in. And Xset waltzes right in to start this one off, though.
It was for free, and they've been able to fend off what Sentinels attempt to do to take it back.
Oh,
it's just down to Tens as they got cleaned up. A beautiful round.
Just routed.
From Xset.
Dougie, this is some impressive stuff right now. We still have a lot of games to play. And anything can happen within this. There's an Operator. Did retake.
ECJ looking at entry things with the Hunter's Fury waiting for another. No, Pure got in around him. Dapper gets cleaned up. The Bladestorm comes on through. Aaron's in a great spot. The swing, the tripwire is there to cause problems as well. Shazam's trying to get a little bit of his own with his Hunter's Fury. Does clean up Def, leaving things in 3v2 in favor of Sentinels. The spike is down. You've got BCJ who's got 2 shock darts and he has the op in his hands. Aeryn has control of Garage, so they have a decent spot here, but the thing is, you're going to have to take the fight to BCJ. If you don't clean him up quickly, what a shot from
now
BCJ to
push.
Get it down to a 2v2. BCJ so patient. Aeryn slowly worked his way while all of that was going down. Again, reestablished control of Garage. BCJ narrowly missing. Shazam's in a sandwich. It's not a good one, no, as Aeryn gets a third on the round. Great round. The Cypher Cage goes up. Oh, my goodness. Excellent shot from Tens to clean up Def. It does get traded out, but that should give him a good bit of room to work with towards A. They are walking to Cypher Util, though.
The great setup by Sentinels here to shut this one down, but Sick actually getting a little concussed there. Couldn't make the shot happen. BCJ takes him down. They get into the site. They try to trade. Now jumping around. Dapper's off his foot, off his footing there, and Pure. Such an interesting cosmic divide because it makes you think whether you want to stand in front of it or behind it. If you're behind it too long, people are coming in the site, so you're always messing with your opponent's initial hold spot. What a cosmic divide to start things off as the shuffle happens. Sentinels don't seem to be too off the footing on this, and Dapper comes up with a few as Shazam helps.
The neural theft comes through as Aeryn continues to dance around. Sickwing and aggressive. The paranoia is going to push him off, but they know exactly where Aeryn is. Getting cooked. Gets cleaned up. Zekin, good for one. It's left in a 1v2. Zom's down to 10 health, but no, it's Sick who stops the bleeding for...
Sentinels are very good at constantly reading what's going on. So they were able to play with the flow of that, get themselves another round, and a fourth would be beautiful here, Doug.
Beautiful indeed. We're looking like a garage C split for X set this time around. Def has gotten pretty far up. There's an op on the other side. Not going to connect. Here comes the run it back. Kent's good for one with the Bladestorm. Going up top looking for the second. Doesn't get it. But continues to hunt, and he doesn't get anything else. Aaron with just 19 health. The spike isn't down yet. The North Hunt is going to come out as well. BCJ's left alone. And he's... No, but it looks like they have left a pretty...
Oh,
my gosh, Def. That's a heck of a way to start things off. So that's going to... That severely impedes things, but they're going to get onto the site anyway. Ten should be able to get the spike down. You're starting to see the remaining members of Exit rotate over. You've got BCJ who's shown up. Pura has shown up as well. But Sick aggressively taking the fight into that cut, denying any sort of entry, and delay things more and more. A great flash. Somehow stays alive. Doesn't take any damage. Looking for more? No. He gets cleaned up at the hands of Pura as Exit slowly starts to creep their way forward and get more control onto the site. BCJ spots Shazam, cleans them up as well as members of Sentinels fall apart. Exit take full control.
It's going to be Sick. They destroy it for him, and it's going to be the quick plant. Cloudburst onto Sick so he can get out, and they are goodbye. Fight tomorrow here. Let's see what happens.
So this has already been an adjustment because it was Tens previously who would dash in plant and dash out. This time it's Sick who has been sent on the kamikaze mission of trying to get it down and then get away. Full site control here in favor of Exit, but they have to understand that they've got to take the fight to Sentinels. They can't just let it go. Aaron drops. Tens going in aggressive as he tries to work his way around as it's just dropping down to a 2v2 Tef, down to 10 health, second on the tap. You've got to fight out. You've got to work your way out of sight. You've got to stick the fight to them. As they both teams are just blasting through smoke. Zekin goes aggressive. Zekin good for one. Looking for the second. Tens on it. Def in the 1v1.
Oh my.
And Tens comes up big.
I mean.
On top of Def, they also have the Cosmic Divide. This looks like it's going to be a hit. Oh my gosh. It doesn't even get started. Never leaves the gates as BCJ already drops one. With the Sheriff, that Shock Dart's going to hurt as well. They're going to have to push it forward and deal with them as BCJ backs up. Continues to buy time, waiting for Zekin and the rest of the gang to show up. BCJ gets a second, gets a third. BCJ is a man possessed right now.
30 seconds.
I'm speechless on actually what's happening right here. We are seeing... Okay, so let's focus on Shazam as he goes through. We'll get back to this because 3v1... Shazam working a little bit of magic here. They are in 1v1 positions. The next shot comes out. That's going to be the trade and fire contact made.
Way, bring that Hunter's Fury online a bit faster if at all possible. But you've already got the Trailblazer clearing out space. Tens with a great pick to open things up. Hunter's Fury out from BCJ. I think it's going to tag anything up. Yeah, they've gotten onto A-Riv.
Very close, and a lot of confidence on this round for Exet. Just out there crouch spraying on these plays, thinking they're going to win the quick 1v1s.
Exet's using a drone to understand there's no pressure mid, so you should have a pretty good idea of where the hit is. Hero's got a lot on his hands. The ult drops, but the Paranoid's going to follow. The Hunter Fury's going to come out as well. As Tens blinded, Pure good onto one, onto Zoms. As he dances around the site, should have a decent spot where Tens is too. The Cosmic Divide comes out. Tens no longer an option. Sick trades it out. As the spike should go down.
Spike planted. Def all the way across the map right now, hearing the spike go down. Kind of has to regain control of all of this area, wondering if someone's B. Do they go without him? Do they not? Looking at utility, it's only a few stars here for Def if he calls back and puts out a few. Waiting for that cooldown to come back on his charges.
Sick has no armor. The Dapper's tagged up. Great curveball. Yep, you see Aaron immediately has to back up, but BCJ holds fast. They're going to swing out. Dapper's in a great spot. Dapper's in a great spot. You've got to check that. He's good for one shot. Good for the other one as well. The 1v1 goes in favor.
What?
Def, the IGL for Xset comes up big again, but is he going to get the defuse? With the From the Shadows, should he choose to do so. But you've got the drone taking short. You've got two members of Sentinels taking long. The question is, will the spike come in? Oh, Pure's offline.
Beautiful, Sick.
Sick looking to get a second. Yep, that's going to open things up. You've also got, at this point, Shazam working his way through short. The rest of Sentinels will follow. Smokes are coming out. They have full control of A. Now the question is, how aggressively does Sick play this?
See, he looks like he's staying in. I love the switch here by Sentinels. You know, I was wrong. It was not the op rush for them. Especially with economy down, they have to figure something else out. And a lot of these rounds,
wow.
BCJ again, have come into favor of Xset because Sentinels are executing utility. This one, they just sneak in. They take it. They go under the radar, and that's what throws Xset off. Now, Xset being on fire, will they be able to retake now as they're just picking them apart? Sick with another one, but it's a 2v1. Can he stand tall versus both Def and BCJ?
He's been tagged. He's got the op. Or, excuse me, he's got the ult. Sick
with there
the
it is.
And my gosh, Sick! Oh, wait. A beautiful sight to see.
Absolutely. From what I believe was a sheriff through the armor and then Zabadi. But that feels good. No ultimates needed.
The spike down as well. No member of Xset has really made their way past Garage or from Defender Spawn.
Again, fast strat. Not setting up to let Xset figure out where they can pressure, where they can get audio cues. BCJ answers with the Hunter's Fury. Seekers come out now, and these are the things they have to worry about.
My gosh! Def just goes nuts there. Swings out through double doors. Gets both of those picks. Huge kills from him. Leaving Sentinels in a 2v5. The Cosmic Divide's going to come out. The Neural Theft comes through as well, but Zoms stands alone, looking to make magic happen. One, spam through the smoke, and that's all it's going to be.
On that round, well, Tenz did rip his out there, so you got that, but we'll see if Xset can fire back here. Sentinels may be up with the Phoenix on Haven. Now it's in the mid. He gets to that middle area, the tower. And now it could be even bigger. Damage takes two. Spike, and now Sentinels can move accordingly as Shazam whips out a beautiful shot. What? Yo, Sentinels are online to start pistol.
That ghost is just problematic at best, and they read it, right? Like, we talked about the wall going up and oftentimes what that tells, but the elbow push was the one thing that was a slight difference. What is on the other side of that pyramid? If ECJ is able to stay alive, you've got to remain control. You've got to maintain control of caves here because you've got excellent post plants, lineups with the Viper's Pit, but you've got to stay alive. You've got to keep control of that. Second drop, Sick going in aggressive, looking for another one as the spike continues to tick away. The tap has been defused, but he drops. Sick going in aggressive. Aaron's going to get cleaned up as well. Aaron looking for more. His BCG's there. He doesn't have any more util. The kills come through, but Sentinel. But it's actually going to be a hit towards B. Keep in mind that BCJ has the Viper's Pit. Great pick on Aaron. The Seekers are going to come out as well. Here we go. Now the hit's going to come through. Sick. Managing to stay alive. Let one dash through, but Pure punishes him at the end of the day. The spike is still not fully committed onto the site. You see members of Sentinel start to rotate.
Really neat seeing the distant Killjoy ultimates here to create opposite rotations. Great position to catch a shoulder of Deft here before Deft would see him. That's an easy frag. X gets the second one. Starting the pre-fire as well. Just feeling it right now. Tenz with some beautiful aim.
Standing ahead.
Beautiful indeed. And again, like, this is another gun round, right? Pure has to go in aggressive. There you go. The Blade Storm good on one, but it gets traded out. Zekin with the flash. It got cleaned up. Investing the second. The spike has not really made its way past caves at all. It's just BCJ who's up, right? Like, working the middle of the map. First, it was Sick who got cleaned up thanks to the Marshall shot from Def, but with oh my gosh! What? Def got onto one as well. Now we understand why they're buying those Marshalls as frequently as they are, because if you can do stuff like that. Sorry, look at how defensively, look at the investment of utility from Xset, right? You've got the alarm bot, you've got a turret, you've got tripwires to make sure nobody's pushing in. You have to approach this map that way because it's so big and because there's so many different things to control.
Oh my god! Zoms! 2, 3, 4. He just does not stop once you get that ripcord.
Oh, here they go. They're going to go again. A little rinse, a little repeat, and so far, the outcome has been slightly different. But Zoms is going to get a chance to pull off heroics again. He's going to switch out. BCJ actually cleans him up. So they've gotten onto the site. Another one drops. The Viper's Pit's going to come through. And you've got to keep an eye on Def as he's on the rotate. But he might get too late, right? Like, if the spike doesn't get there in time, there he goes. He's one onto Shazam. Dapper's the last one standing.
By KJ. That Dapper has set up right after the alarm bot. So you're a little deterred, but you still want to make the entry. Looks like they get the mollies out. They're good to go on this as those are triggered and they don't take too much damage. But the shots here from Deft and BCJ to return the favor.
And the Neural Theft to let them know that the two remaining members of Sentinels are nowhere near the site. Now they're going to start creeping their way forward. So it looks like they're going to work towards door. Remember, Sick has a chance at something. Just waiting for Zoms to get to a decent spot. Members advantage heavily in favor of Xset as Zom works his way forward. Sick already good onto one. Nice little 1-2. Def, great spot to clean one up, but that's going to leave Zoms alone. Zoms in a 1v2! turret, giving his position away. He's got to clean that up. He's not going to find any way forward. Aaron swings at just the right time to guess the Seekers as well. So Tan trying to blast through the smoke, or through the wall, excuse me. Not going to get anything going. Now they're going to work their way in. Dapper, good for one. Zom's got one as well as Dapper continues to encroach forward. Members of Sentinels will follow. Aaron is already backing off. BCJ and Pure are looking to do the same, but they're a bit stuck, right? Like, because of where they are on the map, they can't easily work their way out. They're kind of stuck here, Pure.
Here.
Making things a bit easier as he gets a shot onto Sick.
And you can see how patient Sentinels are right now. Still have one on the B rotation. Feel like they're covered fine on the site. Nothing that Xset is doing is putting too much pressure on Sentinels right now with how they've set up this defense. Good rotation over from Zoms to start calling info in the site. The 1v1 for BCJ and Tenz comes up big.
The timing. He just happened to be jumping up at that exact moment as Tenz swings around, leaving Pure alone in a 1v4. He's got the op. He's got the Blade Storm, but that might be all he has to his name. A pretty brutal spot, but the thing is, Pure had some magic to him yesterday in these moments.
Put that padding on for second half here.
So Sick invested the Seekers at the beginning of the round, cleared out a couple members, and he gets the kill onto Pure. So that's big control established already. Zom's looking to return to the scene of the crime a couple of rounds ago. Shazam getting the best onto Def here, and for Xset, my gosh, they just haven't really been able to move around much at all. They haven't had the freedom to breathe.
Yeah, Ten's already behind him, whispering in their ear, sweet nothings with that Phantom as they all, oh my word, the Guiding Lights come out and just send everyone into a bit of chaos. Towards B, I should say.
Sick has already taken elbow control, but you see Def and Zek and Wise to it. Yep, Sick gets cleaned up.
Though, Dapper, the 1v1 coming through. Oh, this could be big, and it's going to be Aaron with the model just a little bit farther from that angle to finalize the kill.
Do the same. It's been crispy shots across the board that have gotten them to this point, and they just continue to pile on. Def gets the third. Sentinels just down to tens. Chofton times is plenty from Xset, and yep, it is going to get cleaned up. Def patting the stats as he gets to stay alive. You've got Def moving in for a nice pinch as well, but it's going to be a big kill on the Sick. If he's able to get it, doesn't understand, is literally right under his nose. Is he going to check it? No, he's going to drop right in front of him.
Oh my
god. Sick lands the shots. Aaron looking to give it back. And yes, he trades that out. Zoms with one health gets cleaned up at the hands of BCJ. A 3v3 here as Aaron continues to creep his way forward. Make that a 3v2. Looking to equalize things even more. Oh. The Ghost does the damage. Looking for the last line. Him up and knock him down. Aaron
in advantage, and then you make your hit. Little watch here in mid from Dapper as it looks like it's going to be finalized A.
Yep, and they're controlling. Again, you see the value because flanking is so prevalent. My gosh. Prevalent on this map. You've got to control double doors, and that's exactly where he is. Sentinels have gotten onto A.
Spike down.
Aaron,
A.
Good for one. He's got the lockdown as well, so he can really make some magic happen. He's already got the kill onto Shazam. Tenz cleaning him up, leaving BCJ alone. He's got a Bulldog. Spike and he has some armor. Just doesn't have much else. He doesn't really have util. He does have the element of surprise, but it's going to be given away right now.
Knock, knock.
So much for that. Great shot, though, on Zoms to get things down to a 1v2. CJ, how much more magic do you have in you, BCJ? Good for one, but 10 swings at the right moment to get three.
Alone in mid right now. Dapper's on a mission.
Def has not left A, so he's in a great spot.
Oh,
get a chance at something. There it is. The judge delivers. BCJ got messed up forward and continues to do so. Great shot from Pure onto Sick as well to control that flank. So now, all of a sudden, you see Sentinel's resources and their numbers dwindle very quickly as it's a heavy advantage in favor of Xset. It continues to go that way. Dapper's alone in a 1v4. Make that a 1v3. You can feel his mighty senses tingling, having to check every single corner. 10 health and a dream was all. He has some of ultimates. The Seekers have been used. The lockdown's going to be used in kind. As Aaron looking to go aggressive. Yes, Aaron good onto one as well. Second lockdown has been used to counter. As the spike is just playing on the fringe of that. You see it in the pockets of Shazam. Two players have been detained, but will they aggressively take it? Will they look for it? Pure missing the shot.
Ooh, they're baiting for him.
Challenge. Oh, Pure gets cleaned up. Sick, just trying to dance around, get control of the site. Zek just narrowly stays alive long enough to land the shots. Oh my gosh, I think he dinked him too, but no, Dapper swings on and gives him the business and dismisses him through all of that chaos. It's just BCJ, who isn't around for long. An excellent round run.
How far is someone pushed up? All retake territory. Six says thank you. His def is in his camera. I think he just backed out of it and maybe wasn't ready for this that instant. But that is a quick pickup from Sick. He's been opening up these rounds huge for the side of Sentinels, coming through his 10s once again through this Viper smoke, and they will go right back towards that A site.
Sick is going to get the spike down as well. They pulled the string on him so well to get that kill onto Def to make
I play on defense, and that's one of the things. You always see the site someone plays, and while they switch, and the team will add a little bit of variety. A player always seems so much more comfortable in playing.
Shazam is 1 point away from getting 100 CR online, and that's exactly what it looks like they want to do. Tense gets cleaned up, but Zoms trades it out. There's 100 CR in his pockets. Pure with the Blade Storm is going to have to make some magic happen. Nope, he drops. Aaron gets one back, though. And the spike is still not on the site. The 100 CR is going to come out from Shazam, and that's going to be entry, but Sick with a couple of filthy shots to open up.
The angles of the site they usually defend and seeing that. And when they come back to it, you're just like, yep. Knows exactly. Look for what elevation has changed and who starts to get up higher. If they all stay on the floor, it becomes a bit tougher, and that's 10's going down right away as they walk it into A.
Zekin already starting off with Arena in perfect fashion as he dismisses. You see some of the prowess that she is able to bring to a map like this, but Sentinel still managed to take the site. Slightly tattered, slightly battered as they've dropped one, but they've managed to take control. Now, it's going to be on X set to retake. They're in a decent spot, but they're starting to drop both Zekin and Zef. And Def, excuse me, have lost their lives along with Pure. Sentinel's just like zero regard for what's in front of them, but X set looking to do a bit of the same as it's just down to one. Sick! In a 1v1 against Aaron, 25 health. He's starting to heal himself up a bit as Spike continues to tick away. He understands where he is. Aaron goes aggressive and Sick rips him right back down. A 4K.
Doing anything tricky. Fast plant with the walls going down here, coming in from Sentinels. And they're looking. Oh my word. BCJ at the last moment, Doug.
BCJ has already denied the spike. Now Zekin starting to rotate over right into the spam, but the wall is there to deny any sort of shenanigans, but it comes down. Tens has dropped. The spike did fall as Aaron's creeping his way around yellow. See this wall goes down and Shazam drops shortly thereafter. They take the fight to Sentinels and they pick them apart. It's just Zoms who's slowly making his way around, but his position of a precautious look, really, from both squads. Oh my gosh, what a pick from Shazam early on.
Operator or not, Shazam's looking for those long shots. Looks like the wall's coming through now. Shells to the right side of A, and it looks like Pure is going to have to back off here, but he doesn't get the chance. Zom's up high, able to take him down, and across the rope they go inside A site. BCJ trying to hold down what he can for a little bit of help.
Yeah, you see Aaron has shown up, but it's a 2v5. Make that a 1v4. 1v3. Not able to get the third. It looks
right on the coattails of BCJ right now. The turn towards Kitchen. BCJ just swings and finds Sick after a game of cat and mouse.
Alright, here comes the spike, and there's the Hunter's Fury exactly at the right time, and he tagged up the player he was looking for, tagged a second. Not able to land the kills, but a decent amount of damage has been done. Now Zom's looking to get the spike down, 10 seconds left, just in the nick of time. Manages to extend the round. Tens gets messed up on the other hands of a judge, and Dapper might be in some trouble too. No, definitely needs to turn around! He's not able to land the shots. Aaron does, however, clean that up. Shazam falls shortly thereafter. Exit get to two. As well, two from Dapper, so they can make some work happen there. But yeah, the spike is over towards B. The dash comes through. BCJ stuffs it right off the bat. Here comes the showstopper, though. Tens buying so much space. The res comes through to deny, but Def's in a great spot. Def not able to get anything other than the first. As BCJ and Def both drop, Sick gets control of site for Sentinels, and the spike goes down. Zekin not going to be able to do anything either, as Pure and Aaron are left alone. They're starting to rotate over, and they're going to be able to come in from different fronts, which is ideal. You're walking into a 2v4.
Really great traded positions here and how Sentinels was setting up this round. Throw off X set. Zom's already on the backside for two, but Pura stops him just for one. And now
Pinks come out there trying to invest that Viper util to control B long. And Shazam being spotted there isn't going to be the one to draw early blood, but Tenz is.
Just feeling the reads this far into the round, knowing that, you know, rifles are up, forward positions are going to be checked at high or low elevation for the A site. A nice, nice read there as they start off the round with a kill onto Def. And Pure tens again onto Zekin.
And it's bait,
he is just on fire now. Can he finish another one? Paint shells out as he gets pulled back. And reads the play onto BCJ.
Yeah, man, they've got to send a firing squad to take her tens. Meanwhile, the play's on the opposite side of the map. As soon as that first pick came through, you saw, who was that? Excuse me, it was Sick, who had already gotten onto B, who had already put the wall up, and the spike wasn't there, but they knew where the play wanted to go. But there's just so much attention that's demanded by tens on that site that they invest everything to try to take care of him just to find out that that's never where the situation was going down. Aaron's good for one and two. There, you still got tens up there. But what they don't know is that there's an op on the other side. Will that be the difference maker? Aaron's already been tagged up. Zoms has been had. His position has been had. We're already seeing some of that op. Palov second tries to dial up a bit of a different aggressive look. He gets cleaned up as the middle of the map is not available for exit.
And Zoms, the wall has not been thrown early. Only when they need it. Only when they need it to use just that poison orb in mid. And there's the res on the BCJ to reset things a little bit here. 4v4. Got sketchy for a moment.
He's back, but he's back with 13 health.
Yeah.
Not a ton to work with. We'll see if Pure is able to make that op. Seeing no, an arrow miss. He's going to dash away, but they don't expect Def. Def going on to one, and Tens gets ripped down as well. Shazam, though, looking to equalize things. Pure still has that op in his hands. What a shot. They even gave him the shoulder peek, the jiggle, but it didn't matter. Shazam's going to get cleaned up. Excellent. Shazam, or excuse me, Dapper, who's still playing back, and they've got him in a pinch. Dapper's in a great spot here. They've taken B. They've got the spike down. Dapper can be the one to blow this thing up if he's able to catch the two remaining members working their way around. Shazam's been spotted. Viper's pick coming through. They have, they have full control of the site. The Hunter Fury's going to come out from BCJ. Tag one. Yeah, he gets the second Pure with the op. Gets one as well.
Oh.
Along with Aaron. As Sentinels just fall apart. It's just Tens and Shazam that remain in this round. Second starts on the tap. Shazam, good for one. He's going to stick it. He's going to have to... No, he does pull off. Tens with 33 health. Satchel out. In a 1v3, but no, there's just no easy way in, right? Like, there's no entry. Sentinels dialed up something aggressive, something different, and XZ stuffed it.
Off Viper's pit on A. Round 11, it's going to be a B.
Pure starting to feel himself with that op as he gets an early pick onto... onto Sick. Shazam not able to replicate that success, at least quite yet. So we're back to where we started, right? We're back to a defaulty look, and that's almost necessary when you've got a Viper's Pit right off the bat. A great pick from Def to open things up as well. On to Dapper, but Tens.
Again, mid and create pressure, but we talked about the no flanks earlier. You always have to be watching, or you have to be committing to what you're doing here. We see Shazam take a little bit of an advantage of that, but he's got his work cut out for him.
He's looking to try to keep the op, and well, forget about keeping the op if you can. Got to commit to doing this. Pure has heard it. No, oh my gosh. Oh, that's pretty.
You think Pure he's made that shot? Holy moly, they're moving forward.
It's going to be fast from both, right? You've got the Bladestorm and the Showstopper, and you've got
Nop
in the hands of Pure, so they're both going in aggressive. Pure, Bladestorm winning the duel against Shazam. The res is going to come out, though, as they're going to double down on the efforts. Tens with the Showstopper, not connecting to anything as he gets ripped down from the skies as well at the courtesy of Zek and Op still in hand of Pure, and the spike has not made its way past 410. There hasn't been a way in. Shazam's going to drop for the second time. Zekin goes in aggressively. Pure up from the top rope, gets dropped at the hands of Sick. The wall goes up as Sick looks to get in a bit of elevation as well. Zom's dropped to 4v2, heavily in favor of XZ here. I say heavily now, 3v1. As Dapper's the last one standing. Dapper, filthy shots. He's got 3 health, Riv, and that's all he's got. A Sick.
They have a bit of chance to clear what's yellow. What's it? Long B? And it looks like everybody, no, 2-3. 3 long B, 2 on yellow. Let's see how they can defend this one with gas walls going up and down, Doug.
You got Aaron, who also still has 1 snake bite left. You see him playing back for a couple of post plants. Sick on the tap.
There's shells.
Yep, and Aaron has already used the snake bite as well. So you see that going in aggressive. You draw that out early on, and now the fight can ensue. Zom's waiting as the wall goes down, and hello, surprise! There are a couple members on the other side. BCJ and Zekin. deals significant amount of damage. His Zekin has already gotten three Dappers left alone in this 1v2 wall. Keeping things at bay, Zekin gets to finish. True, Aaron has put up the wall, so you hear, okay, so you hear the Empress coming online as well. The Leer's gonna come out. Ten should have a great idea of where it is. He had the elevation. Shazam gets a kill onto Pure as well. And using Rune, but Aaron swings around! Wow! Perfect! Play from Aaron to play around that utility and get the kill. Dapper still on the back of the site though, and they have a good idea of where he is. Dapper cleans it up. Shazam follows as well. Here, this is probably their best chance at success. And as the round continues to go on, Shazam takes more and more space away, this time alongside Dapper. BCJ and Def have already dropped as Sentinels with their full grips and fingers around every single area of the map have denied so much space. They've suffocated what Xset has.
Oh,
Aaron. That's gonna open things up. You've got Pure and Zekin both so weak on health, though. Aaron,
oh
good
God.
For another. I mean, those are both flanks.
That's huge this round. Remember what I was saying? There's no flank protection. Shazam, easy frag there. Now the map is completely open.
30 seconds left.
And they have to
but
bite.
It doesn't work. The last one, he tries to meet Tenz and A in the 1v1.
But that was enough. Like, that bought Xset space. Oh, for a moment, bought them space, but Zekin's got to go huge here. 32 health in the 1v1. And he's giving space away, but he's only got 10 seconds, right? He's got to get the spike down, and that's going to be advantageous for Tenz.
Rotation out by 6. It can let them know that they're in the right spot, at least on this partial rotation. Oh, he's under the tube. They're going to be in kitchen right next to each other. Shazam looks up, finds one, but does he know there's two? Zom's onto another one here. We do see Shazam go down on your screen. Zom's continues to answer, Doug.
2v2, 6 in a great spot too. The Viper Spit's gonna come out, but 6 in clean him up. Aaron's left alone. He's got the Viper Spit. He's got a 1v1 too. But he's gotta get the spike with 5 seconds. He's not gonna have enough time. Riv, he's just gotta find the kill,
oh
and no. 6 not having any of it. He's just running for the fences. Shazam also has Spectre in his back pocket. Don't get in your way. Well, I can't get in your way if you're dead. Zekin cleans up Zom's early on. That's not going to be a factor. You hear that Bladestorm, excuse me, coming through. My gosh, the kills come in droves. As Tenz gets the last couple, but Zekin gets the final.
No sweat there. We'll see this push up. Quick flicks in and out, never leaving himself too much in the open. And actually,
from a slight economic disadvantage in order to hand things out for his friends, but Sick. Oh, Sick. Was able to get one, but Pure trades it out. The Hunter Fury is going to come out from Dapper, understanding where Pure is.
Shazam,
not
quick push already.
Shots.
And now Zom's also looking underneath. A nice catch as Pure can't win this round right now.
Yeah, but if they're going back to a day thinking that there's safety because Zekin has gotten all the way in, they have no idea that Shazam is there. Yeah, and that rotation stops. And Shazam was able to get one. BCJ trades it out. There's Zekin on the deep flank. He's been spotted. Dapper gets away with his life. BCJ with the Marshall. Not able to land the shot. Zoms wins that duel, leaving Zekin alone. Now, he's got the Empress. We mentioned it earlier. And both members are weak, so this is certainly a winnable situation. The Leer, not going to find anything quite yet, but he's still got to get to the spike. Dapper's going to run away. Leaving the fight onto Zoms, and Zoms wins that. BCJ channeling the Hunter's Fury. Got a tag on a Shazam, but that seems to be it. Empress has come online. Tenz absolutely eliminates that right off the bat. Shazam looking for a second. He gets that and a third. For Sentinels, make that four.
What?
As BCJ is the last one that remains. That, much like the last couple of rounds, ended almost as quickly up.
And still.
Tenz follows. Yeah.
Pushed up.
Yep. And that's the thing. Like, you don't expect that, right? And you see them pulling off because you heard the dash come away. But Tenz reads him like a book. Good for one. Looking for the second. He gets it.
He was going to wait, but he heard the second person run and knew he had the aim to make both shots, even in the instance of action. Confident stuff coming out of Sentinels right now. They're going to be retaking this one. BCJ doing what he can as he just fires off the chamber. That's empty. Looking for the classic clip. Can he make it happen? And he does not draw.
No aggressive denial of space from Sentinels. Oh boy, here we go. That's a cue. That's a green light for them to
go.
The Showstopper gets one. And that's all it is. BCJ was able to trade it out, though. The res is going to come through to equalize things back to a 4v4, but the spike has not made any progress. Zekin does have middle of map control. As you see the rain on your minimap holding things down. Ultorb is going to go into the pockets of BCJ. Eventually. A bit delayed, but it is going to happen. Six in a great spot. Sick, good for one. Not able to get the second. Pure swings around.
There are so many rounds that timer is blinking red, Doug. Xset pushing it to the limit each time. This time is working for them. They're able to get the spike down. Now 45 seconds on the clock for Sentinels to change this round.
You've got Dapper, who's blinked so far back, but manages to get the kill on the second anyway. Shazam with the op. Cloudburst is buying him some space to move as they slowly but truly encroach a bit closer at 2v2. Pure just waiting. Def spots one. No, Def's not able to get it. It's going to be Pure in that 1v2 to keep the round alive. He's good for one. The 1v1 as the spike continues to tick away. Who's going to peek first to dash across? Pure? Who's going to get tapped? Dapper's going to stick it. Dapper gets it to half, and then he pulls off. Pure's still waiting around, but it's just a second tap as he's just waiting, playing right around the Rosie. Pure goes absolutely nuts. A Red Bull clutch to keep the map.
A quick jump up the steps as he once again tries to take control of Kitchen.
Exactly, the timing's so good there because as soon as the wall goes down, you see Dapper was starting to rotate. They've gotten up the Kitchen, but you got Dapper there, good for one. Sick was there as well. Def comes up absolutely nuts for Xset as he gets a couple Zoms. Leans up BCJ, leaving things in 3v2 in favor of Sentinels. Sentinels looking to avoid overtime. The Viper's Pit's going to come out. Oh, as Def equalizes things to 2v2. 3 for Def. As he gets the spike down. No, Tent
over the shoulder.
That? Oh my gosh!
Just over the shoulder.
Def with 40 health. As they're going to have to work their way through the Viper's Pit to make this happen. Zoms with a great spot onto Def. It's just Aaron. Now Aaron still has that Viper's Pit online. If there was anyone to die there, fortunately it wasn't. But the counter Viper's Pit's going to be used, so it's just going to be green jello across everyone's screen as Tens tanking forward, going aggressive. The Blast Pack not spotting anyone. Aaron may spot where he is, but is he going to drop down? It hasn't been tapped yet. But you hear the footsteps coming through. He knows where it is. He knows where the ping is. But then the second half, Aaron wins one. Looking for the second Zom. So weak. He challenges and Aaron does it again. Another Red Bull clutch. Oh, baby, we're going to over. Still have to get the spike down.
Spike planted under that slow orb. It's going to be tough to get out right at first, but it looks like they'll be able to set up the defense. Now the flank is being watched. A fast strat is the only way that we're really going to be able to set up the knowledge that no one was behind them right away, and that's what Sentinels have done. Let's see if they can execute their post plan.
Shazam up top, understanding where the pressure is going to be coming in from. Shazam's good for one. Tenses as well. My goodness, Xset hasn't been able to work their way in at all as Sentinels refuse to give an inch. Of course, as I say that, Shazam drops, leaving BCJ, however, to make magic happen. No, he's going to drop Sentinels for...
Sentinels, it seems like they kind of thrive in that chaos. You can kind of equate that to their B-Haven strat. In, out, clean, and make sure you just take down the opponents as they rotate in a bit.
Yep. Yeah, exactly, but
that alerts him.
Yep, that dart should tell him that something's going... Oh my gosh! Dapper, what a flick! Shazam gets one as well. Looking for the second. Yep, able to get it. The dash away somehow stays alive as BCJ's not able to clean him up. Def, however, working the middle of the map, opening things up a bit for Xset. The thing is, BCJ's on an island here by himself. He's gotten onto the site, but he doesn't have very much as far as like resources around him. He's got the spike, but he's got to wait for his teammate to show up. He can't easily plant the spike here without fear of getting swung on, and that's exactly what's happening. They pinged him out. They know where he is. He's going to need some help. No, the jump up. Shazam punishes Def. Good for one. 1v2. 9 seconds left. He's got to get the spike down. The tap. Oh, he's going to run out of time. He's going to have to do this. He's going to have to do this old-fashioned way.
He's got enough.
Ooh, but he's going for the kill. Def with 38 health. He's got the res.
Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh, Zoms! Coming down from the rope just in the nick of time to pull.
It seems like it's pretty methodical for them once they're able to get in that quickly.
How they choose to prioritize that.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, towards B, right, they know that nobody's pushing in. At least they haven't worked their way through yet, but they're not wise to the fact that both Dapper and Shazam are pushing their way up. Ten's already gotten one. Seriously messes up. Another is BCJ so weak, and there's that pressure that we were talking about, right? They just full send. They do not give their opposition a single inch to work with.
They're playing off of each other too, right? Tens knows one's peeking on Cat, so you continue to peek. It's like ducks going across the row. Which one do you shoot? Fantastically played here by Sentinels to start the pace off hot. Looks like they're just looking to finalize the last few kills. Pierre is going to come around and try and bolster the group here with the cavalry. I don't know if it's going to work, but BCJ starts them off a little bit, right?
A little something. Zekin gets one as well, but now without Shazam getting one, Zekin gets two. So now, and Zom's never left A, right? So they wisely apply pressure B through garage, they apply pressure through mid, and they stay at home on A. Haney's got a Guardian. Risen in prominence since the latest patch, and you start to see why. It's more effective from a financial perspective, and it still hurts.
Yep.
Hits like a damn truck. Zekin's already dropped.
Ooh,
oh, wow. For halfway to having the Hunter's Fury online, we seem to continue to prioritize that. While for X set, I mean, full, right, they know. Right, they're making no doubts about where they're trying to go from an audio perspective, but Dapper was able to take care of Pure. Tenz is on the site, but he only got 40 health. Oh, and he's not on the site anymore. Great positioning by Def to win them that and leave Sick. And a 1v3, now he's got a Ghost, and he's got a wall, and a Hot Hand. So he's got something to work with. The turret, Def, is he going to swing on it? No, just patiently waiting. Six in a brutal spot here. He's going to have to work things around. Waiting to see if anyone's going to be...
One for BCJ.
See some investment of utility towards B early on. Ult orb going into Zekin's pocket.
Push up.
This time, quietly but surely, takes more of an aggressive position and gets rewarded with a kill. Sick on the other side of the smoke. He's got a Sheriff. It's getting blasted through, but no, he's worked his way around. The audio cue's going to give him away. And from that, he backs up. Avoids disaster. Now the Hot Hands, the flash is there. Sick gets cleaned up. Very well played by Zekin and Pure as well. Tenz was able to get one. He's still up in heaven. Somehow manages to get a second. His Zoms does as well. Things look so good for Xset.
Dog, what's happening right now?
I don't know, man. I don't know, but I'm here for it. I'm along for the ride.
Punch for punch on these rounds. The Sentinel pick up round number 3 after losing. After picking up pistol round. We'll have to see here. We are watching Tenz. Zoms as well, just back on A site. Jenny, BCJ are on the corner. He's been one of the focal points for X set. And now he comes in. The ultimate's up, but he has no time to grab it. Oh my god! The heavy penetration! It doesn't look like they're using that for too much of an idea. It was bait indeed.
Not able to. So we tagged up Tenz, but that's all it was. And BCJ so consistently will tag one with the recon dart and then use the Hunter's Fury. The Seekers have come out as well as they've dashed their way onto the site, but Shazam! The Anchor not giving up anything as Pure drops. Dapper gets in on it as well. Flashed up, but Shazam, the shock dart. Ooh! The shock dart, but Sick goes in. It's just BCJ. Can you do it again? A 1v4? Surely not, right? With 13 seconds left, they're just kind of waiting it out. He's going to get taken out. Dapper!
Oh!
And Tenz down with 46 health. Sick got tagged up as well, make that 20. Oh, but he's got a shorty. He's got the flash. The flash's not going to do, or excuse me, the shorty's not going to do anything as the flash paves the way. But the members of Sentinels rip Xset to shreds.
There you go.
You should run.
So you see him on the opposite side of the map. You mentioned the lockdown, but on the opposite side of the map, they've taken space away through garage. He's got the op and the blade storm, but Zoms gets dropped instantly. So they are going to have easy access onto A. Keep an eye on the minimap. Because Def is getting a little impatient. Tenz is on the other side as well. The spike's going to go down. Neither of them are wanting to move. Who's going to go first? Oh, it's going to be Def. Oh, it's going to be Def. Oh, no, it's going to be Def. Tenz and Sick both get a kill almost at the exact same time. BCJ trades one out, though, as the spike has been playing at Shazam from up in heaven. Looking to make it happen. Nothing doing. The op holding that tight angle. You can't really wake your way in there.
No, and you can see they set up for this too. Cypher trap on cat, Cypher trap on mid. So Sick could be present. Misses the rear end. And now it's going to be Death safe after that one. Does he still live though? Pure takes down Tenz as he continues to rush forward. And Xset are off and running here on Raid Storm for him. He's going to rock it right off the bat. And Sick back to Garden the Arc Orb. Oh! Sick throws the Molly, runs up, so they focus on him. Tenz plays the bait game as he flies over the wall.
Excellent use of teamwork and excellent use of the Cosmic Divide online. And they do still have some util, so CJ presumably could get some... Okay, never mind. Forget it. Forget I was saying anything. When you've got Tenz doing things like that with the Blade Storm, what kind of options do you have? Not able to land the last.
There he goes.
Hunting. He wants it. He got it, baby. An ace for Tenz. Divide it.
So the turret here would definitely activate to whoever's in sight. And I think they realize this is going to be a B hit, unless it's just the biggest fake with a lot of utility used here. Doug Aaron starts it off onto Tenz immediately.
The Cosmic Divide and the Seekers follow shortly thereafter. Sentinels have to peek through that wall to get some space. Dapper's still on backside, though. Lockdown online.
Right.
Look at the patience with which Xset swings round.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Oi! Yep, 10's good for one on death. Gonna dash away. Sick. Looking to make something happen. Lockdowns come online. The hot hands cooking things up as the spike
He's
goes
ready.
Down. Yep, sick with the flash. Aaron tries to turn it. Not able to do so. Looks like he's going to try to get away here. Pure with the op, creeping his way forward. Spots one, not able to land the shot. Flick just narrowly missing. And not battle here as both jets looking to make things happen. They both go up. They both go up aggressively. Sick has already dropped. Zekin, not able to land it. It's Pure gets one on a Shazam.
We'll tag
for another. Oh, the op battle. Yeah, Pure wins that one with the classic.
10 seconds
Dapper
left.
In a 1v2. He's got a great spot, though, but they've got to know where he is. Zeki gets messed up. The Cloudburst bought some space.
Or
he's going to have to get the spike down. Dapper goes in aggressive. Dapper clutches it out for Sentinels.
11 now.
Pure has activated the Blade Storm. See a cheeky little one-way. Shazam looking to go in and get some info. 10s with the peeking through. The flash is there. He has to back up. And you've also got the gravity on the back of the site. Pure has been cleaned up. The Hunter Series is going to come out as well. And 10's good for one. Take that a second. Sick falls as well. 10's for three. Understands where fourth one is. Spots him, not able to do it, but Shazam in. Back up, ECJ using the Hunter Fury. You hear the run it back is going to be used as well from Sick, but he walks right into a Seeker. Excuse me, a Flash. Sick. Oh, Sick, not able to get anything. Pure with the Frenzy. Does what is needed. Zom's going to get cleaned up as well, but here comes the rest of Sentinels. Dapper and 10s. Don't give up anything. Zekin trying to make it happen. Makes it a 1v3, but he's got 33 health, and that's all.
Take four Sentinels. Let's see.
Yeah, it was an excellent response from Xhead, understanding that that's where the pressure was coming from. We talked about the tells. That's going to be it. They bunker. They, yeah, hunker back down on backside, but Sentinels
oh,
full send.
My
Tens
word.
Going. Tens does it again as he gets two. Aaron's left alone. They've gotten full control of B. They're going to get the spike down, pitch a tent, have lunch, do whatever the heck they want back there, as Aaron hasn't been able to work his way in at all.
Open the floodgates. Just waterfall coming in from Sentinels. They drop into the site, overwhelm Xset on his pistol. And now it's going to be any rotations just yet, but he is waiting to hear if somebody goes by him.
There it is. They managed to get both Ult Orbs in six hands to get the run it back. Def's able to clean it up without any damage done. And really, nobody's able to follow that, right? So they still haven't gotten in. But Tens on the flank through the middle of the map may get right behind Def. He's not careful. Def swings out. Tens. He's got audio cube one left. On the right. 1v5. Nothing doing. BCJ cleans it up. A flawless round from.
And three in sight. The waterfall was able to overcome this last time. From top down, Tens gets it started.
BCJ trades it out. Def's in a great spot, too. He's got to be. He's on the flank. You've also got Aaron on back site. BCJ good for a second. Zom's and Dapper, however, trained it out. Aaron's got to go big. No, nothing happening. It's all going to fall down onto Zekin's hands. He's got a Spectre. Doesn't have the element of surprise anymore. The spike goes down. As he's got to slowly creep his way forward. He's upgraded to a Phantom. Smoke's coming through. Zekin has to play this so carefully. Trailblazer going to give him info of at least where one is, but there's not a tag, right? There's nothing to really help him. Spam through, but
got
he does it anyway! On to Dapper, a 1v1 now, but the clock continues to tick away. He's going to have to go. Zom's getting impatient. Zom's looking to go aggressive. Zekin's going to be on the swing. Zom's comes up big for Sentinels. Yeah, timeline in it. From the end of the last half into the beginning of this half, it's really been all Sentinels. And
yep.
You talked about, we'll touch on this in a second, because the Hunter Series come out. Pure swings out for two. Sick trades it out, however.
One enemy
dropping
remaining.
Things down to a 3v2. Make that a 3v1. Six left alone. He gets cleaned up.
Okay.
An excellent response from Xset, right? And they're walking into it. Tens has been tagged. The Dart as well, but they're going to push right into it. Yep. They just stick it to BCJ. Run right at him. Pure with the Blade Storm, however. Dashing away. Looking for a second. No, the hot hands in the shots from Sick. Take care of business. They managed to get onto the site. They're going to get the spike down as well. You were talking about expensive investments. Pure had an op that round.
Yep.
He's been dropped, and there it is. Six going to get it. Now it's in Sentinel's pockets. That's huge.
I mean, there's two objectives on the board now.
Well,
get that operator out. One's down. Now it's the spike acting as another member here of Sentinel. So almost like a 3v3 is what Xset has to work with. They take one of those members down. Just Zoms and the spike.
Got some mobility, but that's all he's got. And he's Jay. Now he's going to get the run it back as well. Trying to work his way back into the site. Trying to work off of the tag. Not able to do it. Def took a little bit of damage, but that's all it was. Zom's getting the spike down as the lockdown comes through, but it's... I mean, it's just going to funnel him back into
yeah,
the site.
Distant.
Right? Like in a boathouse.
At least they know nobody's clear. This is going to allow Aaron to know that nobody kind of pushed out far enough, but... You still got to make a move here. Zekin to take one down and start it off.
But they're disjointed. You've got to wait for Aaron to push in with you, right? Like, don't take this at a numbers disadvantage. But Zekin, I guess if you've got Zekin, you can do it that way. Def gets one as well. As Shazam is left alone with the Sheriff. One. Ooh. Not able to get anything else. Aaron gets it a few.
Tell him. And Pierre gets himself into a one-shot position to make sure he gets back to safety here. All the flashes and util coming in. And it looks like Sentinels are forcing that in.
That's big. Oh, that's so big because now they have tree control as well. Pierre is going to have to go absolutely nuts. And so far, so good. He's gotten two to drop things down to a 3v3. But Sick Managers has managed to get onto the site. Def slowly working his way through tree to reestablish control there. That's going to force Dapper to take the long route all the way back in towards A main to make something happen. Meanwhile, Shazam looking to equalize things right now. Cleans up BCJ. Pierce still has that op. Understanding there's somebody down low. He's going to drop. He's going to land the shot. My gosh, but Dapper on that flank that we talked about, dude, dropping things to 1v1. Def going aggressive. Dapper waiting for it. Def spots him. Dapper's running for the fence. Get me the heck out of there. He's going to be able to blast through. Is he going to be able to blast through the boxes? No, the spike continuing to tick away. Def's running out of time, and Dapper does it anyway. It doesn't matter for him this time. He may be able to get tag on him anyway. Tenz dashes through. No, the Guardian shot's not able to land. Tenz gets in on the site. They push off the remaining members of XZ, and they're going to have full control of B with the Neural Theft as well.
That's so big. The earlier in a round you can use Neural Theft, the more profitable it can become with that return on information. So they know just exactly where everyone is coming from. It'll dwindle in that sense, but safe in the site. This could be big from XSET to make sure a lot of the members of Sentinels go down, but the round win is the priority, Doug. And it looks like with the Guiding Light coming through, that's going to happen now.
Keep an eye on Zombs on your mini-map as well. He's working the middle of the map. He's going to pinch in behind them, but will his teammates be able to stay alive long enough for it to have an impact? Shazam with 50 health, not able to land the shots onto the back of the site. Now Zom shows up. It might be too late. Nice map to take it to series point. Keep an eye on Def. He's on the flank. The tripwire is going to give him away, but Aaron playing tight in the smoke, able to take care of that ult. The door is going to go down. Spike has not yet, but Def's in a great spot. You see how they have to pull back because of the tripwire? Oh my gosh! Tenz jumps up, gives it to him, is able to get away, looking for more, and he gets it. Tenz continuing to do that. Just two members left on the side of XZ. Make that one. Aaron in a 1v4 to keep the series alive. And who else?
On the close peek, it draws the crosshair down. He's done it.